that we often observe is that people forget to drive their chest up and proud so that we can set.
Hey guys, today we're going to take a look at the trap bar deadlift. We're going to look at how to set up and execute the trap bar deadlift and why this is a variation that you should be doing. First, we're going to look at what makes deadlift important. Now, most deadlift movements are going to involve some form of hip hinging movement pattern. So we'll get Andrew to demonstrate a hip hinge movement. So face the camera, yeah. Driving the hips to the back of the room, keeping the chest up. Good, drive your hips through and squeeze. One more time, hip to the back of the room, drive your hips through. Hips through and squeeze, good. Now what makes a hip hinge such a valuable movement pattern is that not only does it allow us to strengthen the posterior chain muscles, which is gonna look at the hamstrings, your glutes, we're gonna look at, you know, the spinal erectors and even get a bit of lat, rhomboid and trap in there. So basically all the muscles that encompass your backside, which are gonna be crucial for whether your goals are performance, whether your goals are maximizing hypertrophy or strength, or even if you're just looking at having a healthy body with good posture, this exercise is gonna tackle them all. All right, so now we're gonna take a look at how to set up and then execute the trap bar deadlift. Now the first major difference between the trap bar deadlift and the straight bar deadlift is that unlike the straight bar, the trap bar deadlift is going to allow you to stand in the middle of the bar and use a neutral grip by your side, which is going to allow you to distribute your weight a little bit more centered, and it's going to be a little bit easier for most people to get into this position properly as a little bit less mobility demands. So, the setting up the trap bar deadlift, first we want to look at the feet. We want the feet somewhere between hip width to shoulder width, okay? Andrew's preferred stance is hip width. From there, we're going to think about pushing our hips back as we go down to reach the bar, which Andrew's going to demonstrate now. Pushing hips back, reach the bar. Good. Now, from here, we want to set the back nice so that it's supporting the spine and so that we've got a neutral spine. So we might come a little bit more around the side. We want to think about pulling the shoulder blades back and down into the back pockets of your pants, sticking your chest out nice and proud, okay? What that's going to do, we pull the shoulder blades into the back pockets of your pants so that we can engage and activate the lats, which is going to allow us to create more tension and stability throughout the lift and therefore express more strength. From there, we get two simple cues. First cue is we think about pushing the floor away. Second cue is driving the hips through and locking out. We'll demonstrate that one more time. So hips back, reset, shoulder blades down, chest up, push the floor away, hips through and squeeze. Good, let's do one more. Again, shoulder blades down, chest up, push the floor away, hips through. Good. And that's how you set up and execute the trap bar deadlift. So now we're going to take a look at three common mistakes we often observe in the trap bar deadlift. Now the first mistake is squatting the trap bar deadlift. So oftentimes what we see is people try and get too much knee flexion, so get into a squat position. As we can see here, we've got too much knee flexion and we're putting more of the load onto the quads, whereas a deadlift movement, we want more of the load to be placed onto the hips and lower back. So how we change this is we want to think about pushing the hips to the back of the room. So push your hips back, okay, and chest up. So what we want is we want the hips to be higher than the knee, and we want a relatively vertical shin angle so that we're putting most of the load and drive through the hips throughout the movement. All right, so the second mistake that I often observe is that people think about pulling the trap bar up rather than using their leg drive to initiate the lift. So Andrew will demonstrate this, okay? So when we think, as we can see, when we think about pulling the bar up, we lose stability and tightness in the back, we round through the spine, it's gonna increase our chance of injury and put a lot of unnecessary forces on the spine. What we wanna think of instead is think about basically leg pressing the floor away. So we wanna get nice and tight, and we wanna think about pushing the floor away with our legs and hips through, so that most of the drive is coming from our legs and our hips. One more time, push the floor away. Good. Now the third mistake that we often observe is that people forget to drive their chest up and proud so that we can set the spine nice and neutral to be as safe and stable as possible during our lift. So as you can see here, Andrew's got his chest rounded forward, okay, and he's looking down at the ground, and his spine got flexion of the upper back, flexion of the lumbar. What we want then is to cue chest up and proud. So drive your chest up and proud. All of a sudden, we can see that he's got a nice neutral spine, much safer position, and a good spinal alignment. We also want to think about looking diagonally down so that we're not hyperextending through the neck, and that the neck goes and flows on with a nice alignment with the spine. So again, chest up, nice and tight, and push the floor away. Good. And that's how to execute a nice, safe deadlift. So to wrap up, unless you're a powerlifter, you don't have to be focusing only on the straight bar deadlift. The trap bar deadlift is an amazing alternative. It's gonna be safer. It's gonna allow you to get all the same benefits, strengthen your posterior chain, build a stronger lower body, improve posture, and just lift some heavier shit weight. Enjoy.